Greetings. For nearly 142 years, Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University has consistently interwoven the best of the past with the promise of the future. Because of this legacy, our recruitment slogan, Start Here, Go Anywhere, is an ideal fit for the 21st century. Alabama A&M University offers more than 40 excellent undergraduate programs through the colleges of Agriculture, Life and Natural Sciences, Business and Public Affairs, Engineering, Technology and Physical Sciences, and Education, Humanities and Behavioral Sciences. You are certain to find your fit in one of them.
With this play right here, and an interception in the end zone, and that will seal it for Alabama A&M.
Hello, my name is Rodney Simpson, and I'm here to talk to you guys about The Normal Life, a new film being produced by 12 brothers from all over the country.
What you talking about, Willis?
What brings them to college, that's what you gotta watch the film for. While they're down on college, what they went through, gotta watch the film for. But most importantly, what reached out and grabbed me was it was a nostalgia piece, the 90s, hip hop, golden era. Nowadays, we don't get that. We get what they call it, a diluted, you know, expression of art nowadays.
I call it trash, but yeah.
He calls it trash, but that's why we're filmmakers, because we want to make the movies that we need to see. We have to control our own narratives.
Exactly.
So reality TV runs the airwaves, and if art imitates life, we can see where that's going.
You were homeless and destitute. That's what you were.
I'll take starting at homeless, because look at this. Look at this. Stand up. Where's your waistline? Where's your waistline?
Right here, honey.
Talk about somebody like that. She's not here. That's good for TV.
Come on. Hey, yo, Playboy. Okay, let's play that game.
Let's calm
play
down.
Table.
And now back to your regularly scheduled program.
Y'all remember Different World Out There? When that show was on TV, HBCU's enrollments skyrocketed by 44%. So what that says, Rodney, is what?
That says that we need this film. We need you guys to go support it, watch it, stream it, whatever. You know what I'm saying? And also remember all my A&M alum and students that attend didn't graduate like I did. But
talk
I don't owe them any money.
Talk
but I don't owe them no money.
Talk to them.
I need you guys to definitely get involved with this, because this is a way that we can create a platform or bridge for all of kids that go to our school, Alabama A&M University, to get into the entertainment business, because that's what I work in. Been working in it for 20 years, music, fashion, film. You name it, I've done it. But now I'm reaching back to those people to try to help them get in. This is my way of doing it. So make sure you support this film. What do you think, Travis?
Support, support, support. Control the narrative. This is our time. The ball is in our hand. Let's put our film on the screen. Old people, young people, people that ain't even born yet. You know, this is some... I ain't even gonna get into that. You gotta watch the film.
Fund the film.
Peace.
Hey guys, my name is Kahari Baby J. Embry, and I attended Alabama A&M in 1991. Now, being from Chicago, Illinois, it was a culture shock to come down to the South. I didn't know what to expect to come down to Alabama, but I will say, I met some people who are who've been my friends for the last 30 years, have been my brothers, my sisters, my confidants. I've lived with people, we've shared, we've cried. Said we cried, cried,
so, for the youth that's thinking about going to A&M, tell us a little bit why you decided to go there.
I let my sister go first.
Oh, you let me go first? Yes, oh, okay. First. Well, why did I decide to go there? And why I think others should decide to go there. But let me tell you why I decided to go there. I just knew my mom was going to go to Alabama A&M University, but she couldn't afford to go. Aww. So we used to always go to the football games, Alabama A&M versus State, the classic, and I just always knew that's where I was going. I didn't even visit another college. I knew I was going to Alabama A&M University. That's where I applied. And that's where I ended up going, period. It was just point blank. I only lived an hour and a half away. And I just knew that was the school I was going to. So why should others go to Alabama A&M University? Of course, all of our many programs. The one program that I studied, I am a speech language pathologist, and we have a very, very, very good communicative sciences and disorders program, along with all the other ones as well. Yes. I met a lot of good friends at Alabama A&M, lifelong friends that I am still friends with today. And we had a lot of good times at Alabama A&M.
Remember school the talent show?
Talent show?
I had a talent show where she was serenading me. And we step on stage, and we had at least had to be a 30, 40-foot sign. Step on stage to acknowledge my ex-brother and knock the sign down. You remember?
Embarrassed me. Oh, my God.
But then, hey, everybody forgot all about it once she started singing. So, you know, people still remember that, though.
Hello. My name is Dorless, a.k.a. MVP. Gosh, we are here to talk about my alma mater, Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University in Normal, Alabama. I love my HBCU. I knew that I wanted to attend an HBCU while still in high school. I went to a predominantly white high school in Northern Virginia, 150 minorities, not enough people that look like me. So I know that I needed a place where I could see more people like me just from different walks of life, that loved hip hop and rock and punk and goth, but all had the same love of being black. And going to an HBCU, this one in particular, in Alabama, somewhere I had never been, coming from Northern Virginia, I just wanted to be somewhere where my fellow students were my cousins and my aunts and uncles were my teachers and professors. But I just wanted that family connection. Mm-hmm. So meeting my brothers, mm-hmm. and one of my brothers is here mm-hmm. today to tell you about his experience at the HBCU. Mm. Introducing.
My name is Quentin Arrington, aka Link. I'm from Chicago, Illinois. And unlike her, I didn't know exactly what I was going to do, right? I had never even thought about going to a black college before, right? My mom told me, she said, hey, you're not going to school up here. You're going to school down south. And I said, what?
What? Okay.
All right, Mom, whatever you say. So I filled out all these applications. And the one thing about it was that I didn't know anybody that was going to Alabama A&M. So I said, I figured, okay, well, if I'm going to start somewhere, I might as well start fresh, right? And so when I got down there, and I did know one person, my girlfriend at the time, she followed me with me down. We'll talk about that a little bit later. But when I got down there, I was able to meet my brothers, right? And they was from everywhere, Detroit, Alabama, you know, just all over the place. And the one thing about it was, and we meshed together as one unit, right? And experience all these different things. And my sisters, don't get my sisters now. You see how they look, you know? So I got another one just like this one now. But it was one thing about it was those life lessons that we learned growing up at school. And that even to this day, I look back on those things, right? As I get older, up there in the ACL, it's gray. But as I continue to get older, I can always go back to them A&M days. I mean, I don't know about you, but.
Oh, absolutely.
You know.
So I go by the name of Mr. Collie Park, formerly known as DJ Smurf. And my experience of partying at Alabama A&M, it was the wildest, most free time of my life, simply because I wasn't at home with mom and daddy no more. And I didn't have no family to go home to with responsibility. So that's the time in your life, anybody who go to college, that 18 to 21, 22, however old you are in that period of time of your life, that's the last moment of freedom that you're going to have before you enter the world. So for me, and I didn't even know it at the time, that was the most freedom that I ever had in my life. And thank God A&M was such a family atmosphere. When you go to a HBCU, my brother, my older brother was there, so he was already there as an alpha. So when I got there, it was kind of already rolled out for me. I didn't know anything about college. But when I got to A&M, the alphas, from my side of the experience, was running the yard. You know what I mean? So they gave me my first party, the alphas and the band. KKSI gave me my first two parties on a Friday and a Saturday at the end of my freshman year.
Shout out to my fellow alumni that are creating this film about the HBCU experience called The Normal Life. I think it's important for us to have that to depict a true experience of the HBCU. I think there's a lot of stigmas, a lot of assumptions, but we are serious about our education. We are serious about our people. Normal Life will show that, and hopefully it'll be a launching pad so people can recognize the greatness that have come from Alabama A&M. A lot of lifelong contacts and connects, people with all different walks of life, doing all different types of professions. I tell my kids, I tease my kids now and say, there's not a place you go in this country I can't pick up the phone and have eyes on you.
I suggest that everybody go and experience that prior to going out into the world. Pass the education that you get from going to a HBCU. It's that experience that people experience, the networking experience that you get. And I can't tell you how much that did for my music career. All I gotta say is, if you wanna see the world through my eyes, when I was 18, 19 years old, and take a walk through the dorms of Alabama A&M, you need to come watch this movie, The Normal Life. It'll change your life.